The first place to listen to the hottest K-pop. K-popping with DJ Isaac.
Ultimate vote. K-pick is over, and it's time for you to start voting for either Protect the Prince or Save the Eddie, and we have them in the studio. Hi, guys!
투셋!
Hey, yo!
Peter and Freddie Mac입니다!
Hey, guys!
Save the Eddie! Save the Eddie!
Protect the Prince!
I can still taste the horseradish and sausage! Save the Eddie!
Oh, yeah!
Because he actually likes it. He ate it this morning. He's like, hey, Prince made it for me last week. I love it. So he eats every morning now.
I will see you after the show.
Of course you'll see me after the show. Who else are you going to see? Jeez.
Oh, hey.
You finally are wearing something summer-like.
Yes. Oh, finally. You're so fresh.
Your stylist actually gave you something not winter.
I asked for a favor. Please, no more long sleeve. I'm getting hot. Like, people thought I had... tattoos on my arms. That's why they always said I wore a long shirt. I was like, no, it's not. Even in Pops and Zoe, the people that are like, so do you have a tattoo on your arm or something? Why do you always wear long sleeves? But yes, I'm finally into my short sleeves. Summer!
Yeah, he got his tattoos removed, that's why.
Very expensive.
I'm joking.
Okay, so it's time to have these two battle it out. Because they've been whining about doing boy bands, we actually have a girl group topic this week. So you guys are going to be having a lot to talk about.
Yes.
So what are we going to be looking at today? Who are you guys going to be representing?
I will be representing L.O.V.E. Love A-Pink, Son Na-Eun.
Okay.
I'm representing Sapun Sapun. Ah, let me do it again. Sapun Sapun. I'm doing AOA's Solihun.
Yeah, okay. Yes. Mm-hmm. So obviously you're going to be doing talking about these two girls who are pretty much the more innocent, kind of the girl next door. First love type of an image of these two teams. Mm-hmm. So the first love image of these two teams are obviously very beautiful. And they've been very busy these days.
Yes.
They've been very busy these days. Do you want to hear the penalty now or do you want to hear the penalty later?
I guess we'll hear it now.
Oh, okay, whatever.
I don't think it's a big of a penalty for you. I think it's more of a penalty for me. I think our staff members are trying to kill me.
Good idea.
So the penalty today is the loser has to put on the cutest aegyo cringeworthy, OMG, what are you doing? Performance.
Oh. Eddie's good at that.
So, like I said, I don't think it's going to be that bad for you guys. It's going to be bad for me. I think they're trying to kill me with this.
No. Yes.
I was actually thinking this morning, I think Aegyo and like, what is it? It's a prerequisite to be an idol.
No.
Have to know.
Yeah. Well, there's a new one these days. For a while in the K-pop world, the epic cuteness thing was to sing the cute song.
The Kiyomi song?
Yeah, the Aegyo song.
Kiyomi.
Yeah. But these days, I don't know who started it, but everybody's been saying like, oh, I had a bad dream.
Oh.
Yeah,
I don't know. Okay.
Yeah. So they've been. Yeah, no. Everybody's been doing that. Like all the MCs on music programs, all these like female celebrities. Honey's been doing it. It's just like.
Oh really?
Is that the thing that's in now?
I need to see that right now.
Like, all of a sudden, like on variety shows, everybody's just like, I had a bad dream. Like I had a dream. It was a ghost dream. It was a bad dream. Like, that's what they keep saying.
Well, what happened to Himalaya Superpower? Is that still around?
Yeah, it's still around, but that never really was, like, the cute.
Yeah.
That was just, like, a trendy.
The funny thing.
Yeah, it was just a funny
What else has been around?
That's the two that I've been seeing. Other than that,
everyone's been doing this though.
Yeah, it's like everybody's just like, show me your cuteness. It used to be ear doggy, but like now they're just like, oh, I had a dream. I had a dream. It's like I was like, okay,
keep dreaming.
Keep dreaming.
Oh, but oh, honey, oh, she actually did that. I need.
Yeah,
to go,
I saw.
I need to go look this up.
Yeah, you can look it up.
I need to throw something at. Okay, so let's go back to Seonnaeun and Seonhyun for today. So, who wants to start?
I'll just start. Well, with a very simple thing. There was like a voting application, voting poll for Korea's first love, like 첫사랑. Korea's first love, and in first place was 65% with Suzy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm? Oh wait, I'm not doing Suzy. Sorry.
Yes, second place was Yuna from Girls Generation.
Mm-hmm.
I think she was 20%.
Okay.
But the problem is these two are currently dating someone, right? And on the poll, the third place was Seonnaeun with 10%. So you have to say Seonnaeun is number one right now.
Because those two are dating.
Yes.
Well, because Suzy and Yuna, was it? Suzy and Yuna, you said?
Yeah.
They're both are dating, so I'm sure this poll starts again, you know?
Probably.
Yeah, so I think you should give it another go first. So pass that one.
Mike.
Doesn't count. Doesn't count anymore. How long ago was this poll, man?
Okay, so it doesn't count. So then, Prince, it looks like you have something to say. So Prince, what would you like to say about Seonhyun?
Before I get into Seonhyun, I always want to ask a question: is there a nation's first love for boys? Just before I forget to ask the question, I just actually
not really.
But it was
because the first love for guys is more so like the guy you'd like to date, or they use more of like the image of the mom's friend's son, Onsina, of an image.
Like, Lee Seung-gi was first place a couple of times.
Not really, though. He was a mom's friend's son.
Does Korean portray Korea as a male or as a female? Like, say in Australia, we call it Australia a her. I want to go home to her. You know?
I'm not really sure.
Oh.
I know the mother... We call it Mother Earth.
Motherland. Oh, yeah.
Motherland. So I'm guessing it's a her.
Yeah.
Australia's a...
Chance.
The nation's first love. Oh, yeah, okay.
Tim Jung-nim, Chance.
Could you help us out there? But anyways, when it comes to the first love, in Korea, the first love is more of a female image than a male image.
There was a male, though.
Well, I know, but it's not as popular. Because most girls, their first love ends up being somebody who's older than them. Mm. So it's just like the church, you know, the praise band guy, or like the church guy, or the, you know, the guy you'd like to lean on, like the guy next door, that kind of an image.
So was Suzy actually the first one with this love kind of?
No.
Before it was a Moon-geun-young?
Yeah, before that was like Han-ga-in. There was tons of actresses that were like...
I see. And they just change and just move on, right?
I think in the
each gender, generation.
I was thinking, oh, this should be second love now. But all right, everyone's called first love, but okay.
No, they take over the first love image, though, for like that generation, for everybody. So yeah, they become the next so-and-so. But anyways, so jumping into Seonhyun.
I'm talking about Seonhyun, and I think, being a nation's first love, you have to be, you know, naturally beauty.
Okay.
You know, just the kind of girl image, like long, straight, clean. I think Korea, white skin, pure image kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Have to be friendly, have to be young, and have to have that high school girl kind of image and look good in a school uniform or something like that. You know, I think that's what Suzy did. That was the thing that Suzy did, but because Suzy now has a 남자친구. So we have to find our nation's first love.
Well, not only that, the reason why Suzy actually kind of got that title was because she played the younger version of Han-ga-in, who was also that title when she was in her prime.
Yes.
And the movie that she was in, which was Architecture 101, was about first loves.
Mm.
Like, you know, that first love that you never forget. And so that title for her, I think, was even stronger because of the movie itself, because she played Han-ga-in's younger self, and it was about first loves. So it kind of ended up becoming like a natural title for her.
Yeah.
Whereas, what you're talking about right now, describing like the first love images. I mean, guys, your first crush is what? Junior high?
14, 15, 16.
Junior high,
I think
school?
Around there.
So that's probably why the image
I think
that
mine
you
was
think.
My teacher.
like it could have been. I've never understood that. Like girls and guys in high school having their first crush being a teacher. I hated my teachers.
Oh, because I always had a thing.
No, I didn't hate them, but I did not like them.
Exactly. They were my teachers.
I was more of a mommy's boy. Mm. I was like, you know, someone that can take care of me like a mother. And I think when I was in school, the only older, you know, female
was the teacher.
Is a teacher. Mm. So
okay.
Yeah, I remember. I was very young at that time. But yeah.
No, but mostly when you have your first crush or when you start falling, quote, in love with somebody, most people think about junior high school. So all the qualities that you just said is pretty much what I think a guy or a girl would be more interested in at the time. So looking good in the school uniform, having long black hair or brown hair because it's, you know, natural at the time because of school code and stuff like that. So yeah, I think that would be all that you need to be.
But yeah, let me go back to Sohyun. Why I'm saying this because Sohyun in school, that was what she was like.
Okay.
Especially when I looked up a lot of her school photos. And she pretty much hasn't changed much. I mean, she's still young. She's 95.
Yeah.
Like, you know, she probably just finished school not long ago, so you can't change much. But in school, you know, she played the piano since she was young. She came from a family of, her mother was a piano teacher.
Ooh.
She played in the school band. And, you know, she got good grades in school. I think that's also something that, nation's first love like to have, being smart. Being pretty, you know, innocent, because she also wore braces in school. And, like, now she grew up to be, like, a glamorous, what do you call them? Angel?
Aww.
Well, she is an Ace of Angels.
Yes.
That's why I said angels.
True.
Her group's called Ace of Angels. So, yeah, now she grew up to be, like, a glamorous girl. But she did win a competition, a modern competition. So she came from a nerdy, innocent kind of girl, smart girl in school, into this glamorous idol.
You know, like model. Like honey. Sorry.
You're not talking about honey today.
Wrong week, buddy.
But I think
just so you guys can get votes. Oh my goodness. All right. So moving back, Eddie.
Yes.
Let's talk a little bit about Sohyun instead of honey.
Well, talking about let's bring it back to the groups.
Okay.
Like AOA when they first started, they were like, you know, the pure innocent. How do you say more? How do you explain this? More angel-like.
Okay.
The image, but now they went into the sexy image.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they're going a little apart from, I guess, like Korean's first love, like chasarang, that kind of image.
Like but, honey.
What? Anyways, but
don't give me the eye.
But Sohyun and Aping, they've been pushing this their concept from the beginning to even now. Just that sweet, innocent. Pure, that kind of image. So I think Sohyun is more, how do you say?
Fits criteria.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, all right.
In my opinion.
All right, so that's fair.
Different.
That's fair. It's fair. It's different, but it's still different. Fair. It's a good argument. So I'll have Prince think of what he's going to counter-argue.
No, I don't need to think. I can just go.
Because we're going to take a quick song break. So you're either voting for Sohyun, or for Sohyun, or for Eddie, or for Prince. Last week Eddie lost.
Save the Eddie.
I think he's trying to get lucky. If you guys saw his SNS post, he was scratching some lottery tickets earlier.
Scratchies.
Yeah. Anyways, so I think he wants to try and have some type of luck today. So are you going to be saving the Eddie or are you going to be protecting the Prince? It is up to you. Continue to send in your votes. Those are the only votes that we're accepting in our second hour for today. What we're going to do is take a listen to an Aping track and an AOA track. We've got No No No, followed by AOA's brand new single, Shim Kung-hae, Heart Attack. And we'll see you guys after this with more of our Ultimate Vote.
No.
All right, so we just listened to AOA's brand new track, Shim Kung-hae, Heart Attack. Before that was A-Pink with No, No, No. Eddie tried to dance in between when the camera came on.
I apologize for that.
So it looks like that the penalty for today is actually my penalty. I'm going to have to put up with one of these two acting super duper uber cute. Ugh.
Oh, it's not that bad, Nuna. Come on. Well, Prince is a little bad, but...
Hey, man. So mean.
No, actually, I'm hoping that Prince wins.
Yes.
Oh, why?
Well, we kind of saw his cuteness last time.
And it was whatever it is. Yes, I know.
Oh, so mean. So, but yeah, my cuteness is just whatever. So I think it's better if you say Eddie's.
We should make Prince practice more with his cuteness.
I'm just a natural egg yolk. I'm just a piece of egg yolk.
No, you're not.
Didn't he? But wait, weren't you the one that said you were the king of egg yolks like a couple of weeks ago?
I wasn't king of egg yolks. It's just like.
So you lied?
No.
You lied.
Yeah, it moves on, just like the nation's Cheer first love, you know.
Lying, hands on fire.
So the next king of egg yolks is Eddie.
Aww.
Well, yeah. I was always the king, but.
Get out of here.
Okay. I'm glad that I don't have anything that's not expensive that I can't throw because I was about to. I want to throw something. Anyways.
Kitchen cook that. sorry, okay.
I'm gonna throw tissue. I'm gonna throw tissue. Keep everything. Popcorn, I might throw you. I'm sorry, hun. I might throw you. Anyways, so the penalty for today is one of these two are gonna have to give us cringeworthy cuteness. So, yeah, I don't know how I'm going to end the show today. But anyways, that is the penalty. And they are fighting for the image of the first love, which is either going to be Sonnaeun or Seoryeon. Mm-hmm. So who wants to continue on? Prince, you want to take over since he did kind of give a very good point before the song break.
There was no point. I canceled it.
Oh, so if you cancel it, it's not a good point. Okay, yeah. Then Prince, take over.
Oh, okay. Well, you know...
Cancel.
First, her pure looks, you know, she's getting a lot of movies and dramas these days. Like, she did a movie called Gangnam 1970. And it was just about past memories and about that era, 1970s era. And since she acted, actually, with Lee Min-ho. Lee Min-ho was in that movie. She played the role of Lee Min-ho's... younger sister.
Sister.
And yes. You know, Lee Min-ho and Suzy is, the dating.
Again,
Suzy
today was. We're not talking about Honey and Suzy.
No,
come on.
Suzy was, you know, the nation's first love. Everybody, you know, agreed on that, you know. And then so Seoryeon and Lee Min-ho actually did have that connection in the drama, although they weren't lovers, but so, it's close enough, you know.
What
close
are you trying
to say? Close enough to be the next Suzy, I say. I think Suzy is still the nation's first love.
Okay.
But, you know.
No, Honey's taking over, I'm sorry.
No, Honey is something else. Something else. Nation's, I don't know, I can't give a name to Honey. First, fan cam. Whatever, moving on. I'm talking about Seoryeon. I just think Seoryeon is, you know, she captivated a lot of fans just like Suzy.
Mm.
But because, I don't know, because there is Suzy, it's very hard to replace Suzy. But I think Seoryeon is doing a really good job because, you know, after Suzy started dating Lee Min-ho, Seoryeon started getting a lot more commercials and CFs, I realized, especially on TV, on the streets. I started seeing more of her in the past half a year.
Well, Seoryeon has been doing very well as an actress.
Yeah.
Her starring in Gangnam 1970 kind of got the ball rolling. But right now, the current drama that she's in, she's kind of elaborating this first love image.
Was it Orange Marmalade?
Yeah, Orange Marmalade.
Orange Marmalade.
Because
she wore, you know, school uniform in that as well.
True. After the first few weeks of the drama, they kind of went back in time, and I'm just like, what?
But even a character in Orange Marmalade, it was very cute and lively, and it reminded people of Suzy when she was in Dream High.
True.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
It reminded people of Suzy when she was Dream High. Like, I really see her getting a lot of endorsements these days, and I think it could possibly be because Suzy is dating someone now, and I think in the future we'll see more of Seoryeon.
Okay. Okay.
Definitely see more of her.
Okay, Eddie, we're not talking about Honey today.
True, but I think Seoryeon, she's going too fast into the, how do you say it, from the first love kind of image to a grown up image. I think she's going too fast.
Okay.
Especially in her music, in her acting. But Sonnaeun, she has the same image for from debut to now, and I think they're gonna keep on pushing that image.
Okay.
And especially when she came out in We Got Married, you know, people just they just saw her pure innocence right there, her shyness.
No. The reason why I wanted to add to it, I was hoping that you were gonna talk about We Got Married.
Yes.
Because out of the entire show, why is it that I can't? The only thing that I can remember is how dorkily cute those two were when they got matching phone cases.
Yes.
The matching phone cases when Temi and her got matching like teddy bear phone cases. Mm.
These blue and
it's like
blue and pink or blue and brown. I remember I watched it too.
Yeah, it was, but it was the cutest thing in the world. But it was like Taemin and both her had, like, it fit them, even though it was, like, bigger than their faces.
Yes.
Their cell phone cases were bigger than their faces, but it was the cutest thing.
Yeah. And I actually wanted to come out on We Got Married, but anyways, yes.
We Got Married with who?
What?
You still have a chance. With who?
With who?
Honey?
Okay, anyways. Yeah. Huh? What?
Tell us.
Do I have to say?
Yes, you have to say. You're the one that brought it up.
No, I would not go. We Got Married with you, Eddie. I'm sorry.
I have to leave. I'm sorry. I have to leave.
No, I'm sorry.
No, tell me.
Well, yes, it would be great to go on the variety program with Honey. Yes, it would be great.
But are you thinking of somebody else?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes. Anyways. Continuing on, what about you, Prince? If you had a chance to go out on We Got Married, who would you pick as your partner, I guess?
I'd pick Izat Nuna.
Why?
So we can just play games all day.
Finish him!
Okay.
I think we would probably get the worst ratings out of the entire program if we were on.
It's like, you see, like, other couples dating and then...
We're just sitting in a room video playing video games.
Jesus would be like,
do something. Okay.
We'd probably be ordering chicken and playing video games the entire show. That would be really entertaining.
And I'll probably come... Out over. A lot. I come over and come on the TV show a lot.
He'd be sitting in the back with Honey being like, so can we do something?
More like with a picture line.
So mean.
Okay.
No.
So we're not talking about Honey or Suzy today on the show. We are talking about Son Naeun and Seoryeon.
Yes.
So back to Son Naeun.
Yes. As we were talking about We Got Married, yes, she just she really showed her with Taemin her cute and innocent side.
True, she did.
Yes, and I think there was I read somewhere like they did like an explanation for like the first love kind of image.
Okay.
First they must have no surgery on their face, was what it read. Mm-hmm. Second is long straight hair, white skin, and a very clean and pure heart.
Okay.
Third, I think through a drama or movie, get closer when everyone have a lively attitude. And four, like before, debut before 20, no scandals, and has that school look image.
Okay.
Was the like career first love, how do you say, explanations that I saw a lot. And that fits Son Naeun perfectly.
That fits Son perfectly too.
Okay.
Which one doesn't fit her?
White skin.
She does have fair skin,
man.
She got a lot of tan these days. But anyways,
she does have fair skin. What are you talking about?
Sorry,
he doesn't know what he's talking about, guys.
No, he's trying to make a point, but it's not working.
It's not working. So it's not working for you today. But I think Seoryeon is the next generation of Nation's First Love, because Seoryeon has so many possibilities to be the Nation's First Love. You know.
But
this spot it's empty at the moment, right?
Actually, yes, it is right now, currently.
Well, these two are pretty much up for the grabs, so. Yeah.
So when, is there like a, who votes for this stuff?
Online fans. The netizens.
Online
votes. I think end of this year, they'll probably do another one.
Right now, it's summertime, so the biggest one that they have right now is, who would you like to go on a vacation with?
Yes.
Yeah, so who would you like to go on vacation with? Once winter starts coming around, it's probably going to be like, who would you like to go to the ski resort with, that kind of stuff, or spend a vacation with, that kind of stuff. So yeah, I think probably by the end of the year we might get another announcement of who kind of took the spot.
Nation's first love. Yeah. It's every year?
Every year.
Yeah, pretty much.
They should make a boy one.
They have a similar one.
Yeah, like I said, it's similar, but it's not like male first love.
No. It's like different kind of...
These days, I think these days, because the word like flutter or shinkung has become so popular, they're calling like the guys like shinkung now.
Oh, yes.
Shinkung. Like, you know, like guys who make your heart pitter-patter, that kind of stuff. So it's not necessarily like first love. Girls don't really go for innocent guys. Girls don't really go for innocent guys. When you're younger, you go for the bad boy look. Okay. So, wait, bad boy look, why? You want to be the bad boy?
No, I'm the innocent one. I'm sorry. Bad boy's over there, man.
Wow, today's show is unveiling a lot about these two.
I'm the innocent one. That's why.
Okay. Interesting.
Innocent?
Yeah.
Okay. Anne would like to go on vacation with Eddie. So since we're talking about Gwen going on vacation, Eddie was chosen.
Oh.
That was the message that came into our message board.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay, so I'll give you guys about 30 seconds to state some more before we take a song break and come back and find out who's going to have to kill me today with cuteness.
I think it's very hard. I think it's very hard to be First Nation's first love.
Yeah.
You have to be liked by girls and guys.
And guys, true.
You know, guys might all like a girl, but girls don't like them, you know.
Yeah.
And you have to be liked by all ages.
True. Mm-hmm.
Young and old, guys and girls, you know, smart and dumb. Okay. They all have to like you.
Okay.
Very hard.
I think Son Naeun will win this year.
Okay. Okay. So it's between Seoryeon or Son Naeun or Prince or Eddie. So start sending in your votes, and at the end, they might kill me later with their cuteness. The loser has to choose or sing or dance or be as cute as possible till the end. We got AOA with Sapun Sapun Like a Cat, and then we've got A-Pink with Mr. Chun. We'll see you guys after this with this week's winner.
Mr. Chun.
Trust me. Oh.
I let them talk on the mic as soon as it came on, because both of them, I put on my headphones and I looked at Eddie like this, and he's like, oh, I think I lost. And then was like, no, she's not looking at me. I think I lost.
I don't know. Then give me that look. Oh, sorry. She gave me that kind of look. No.
No, I think it's me.
Today, you're not the one that's going to die. I'm going to die.
How about we switch tables around, since we don't know who won, who lost?
What do you mean?
So if I win, I do it.
Winner.
So we switch it around, because we don't know, right?
So the winner do it instead of the loser?
No, it's okay.
We can switch tables around. No, oh, so okay. You think you're going to win this week?
Oh, I think I'm going to win today.
This guy's so fake, man. I'm going to lose today.
I just realized when she looked at me with that smile, that means that I must have won, because it's a punishment for her. But she looked at me with a smiling face. So I think I might be able to win today.
You know what? Do you know why I smiled at Eddie? Because he was complaining about something.
He always does.
He was complaining.
Nice.
So that's why he had a run a couple days ago on the treadmill. So he was complaining about running.
Oh, yeah.
He likes doing other sports, but he hates running. So I was just like, oh, okay, good for you. It was like a very good for you type of a smile, but somebody's paranoid. Somebody's paranoid.
I want to win.
Okay, so our listeners today were sending in votes for either Protect the Prince or Save the Eddie. And that is what you do for our ultimate vote. And even though in between the show today, if you tuned in late, you probably thought that we were talking about Suji and Hani. We were talking about Sumna and Seoryeon. So that was the voting for today. So let's take a drum roll to find out who's going to kill me today. So drum roll, please. The loser for today has to put on the most epic, cutest. And that is true. Eddie has won today. So, Prince, you are going to have to try and kill me and the listeners for the next 45 seconds.
You can either
dance, you can sing, you could talk, doesn't matter. You are going to have to act cute for our listeners.
We are the champ. All right, no, all right. The time is running. Go, 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 go. Come on.
So you can dance. You can say. You can sing the cute That's song.
Oh,
or
man, I don't know what to do. Okay. Supper, supper. I'm so bad at this. This doesn't come natural to me, but okay.
Come on.
Sing the cute song.
What's a cute song?
Hey, doggy.
I'm a little cute song, short and stout. Here is my handle, here is my pelt.
Spout.
Spout.
Oh my god.
Alright, since
teapot,
so now on this week we're going to take a listen to A Pink's Good Morning Baby, and we'll see you guys next week. Bye.
Love you guys.